she doesn't turn up, I'm going to phone her if he doesn't get her.
All right.
She should turn up, but she just got back from... oh, hang on, I need to plug my phone in. She just got back from vacation. I checked with her this morning, and she said she was good. I need to put this in airplane mode. And
we get 7:30. What we do?
7:32.
Oh boy, we're late. All right. Okay, wait for Benoit's go, and we'll go.
I think we're good.
We're good to go. All right, fabulous. Thank you very much indeed. Thank you for being here. And if you're watching online, thank you so much for your support. Thank you for joining us wherever you are. We are the Julian Bond Trio. I am Julian Bond. And I am absolutely honored to be joined by two of the best musicians in the world. On bass, we have Bob Burns. And on drums, we have Don Sanderson. We are going to present an offering of some well-known pieces, some not so well-known pieces. And a couple of little stunts that, a couple of things that I've never done in public before. You'll find out what they are. We figured this would be the safest environment to try them out and see if they work or not. So we're going to continue with an original piece that will be coming out on my CD when I finally get around to finishing it. This is a piece called The Duke.
Thank you.
Thank you so very much. That was The Duke by, well, modesty prevents me. I did say, when we said we would stage this fundraiser for Huxley, that there would be a couple of my friends swinging by to contribute and help out, and one of them is in the audience. This is a lady who I've had so much respect and admiration for I think I've known her 20 years, and she has kindly agreed to do something that we did a few weeks back at the Blue Bamboo. Those of you who saw our concert at the Blue Bamboo remember that a lady by the name of Carol Stein, I hear people at home online all cheering right now, yeah, we know Carol Stein, came up on stage and we improvised a duet. And it was such an amazing experience. I said, we've got to do that again. We've got to improvise another duet without any rehearsal or any pre-thought whatsoever. Carol Stein is in the audience tonight, and I'm going to impose upon Carol. Me. Oh, that's awesome, ladies and gentlemen, Carol Stein. And we have no preconceptions about what piece we're going to play. We haven't arranged anything. So I guess we could throw this open to the audience. Is there a piece that you would like to hear?
Not everybody wants.
Which one's that? The Way You Look Tonight. You know that?
Sure.
We are going to improvise a version of The Way You Look Tonight. And we'll see how this goes.
Thank you.
Carol Stein, ladies and gentlemen. Goodness me. That went to some dangerous places I wasn't expecting. Oh, my goodness. Thank you, Carol. That was so much fun. Okay. How do we follow that? I don't know. A piano trio of some kind? I'm going to... we're going to play a piece that you guys will know. It's a slightly different arrangement that we came up with of a famous television theme. Huxley, this was one of his favorite television programs. Hear me out. Let me explain for those of you who don't know. I know you've read online the story of Huxley, but he was my girlfriend Nikki's companion for at least 10 years, if not longer. Basically was her best friend through some really hard times, and Huxley was the most faithful dog and was almost human in his personality. And to get through some of those tough times, Nikki would very often curl up and watch this particular show, and Huxley would jump up on the bed and watch this show. He loved this show. I don't know what it was about, but anyway. So in Huxley's honor and in Nikki's honor, we're going to play the theme from this show. I think you know it. I don't think it needs an introduction, but this is our little spin on it. So here we go. Theme from show to be announced.
Thank you.
Thank you so much. And for those of you who don't know what that piece was, that was the theme from Star Trek. And if you have not seen Star Trek, you need to go out and watch Star Trek right now. I'm going to give the band a momentary break, a breather, because I have a very special friend in the audience, another very special friend in the audience. Those of you who are here in person are probably sitting there eating snacks. Some of the greatest food you will ever get to taste. Chocolates from Farris and Foster, the greatest chocolates there are. And they were generously supplied by my friend Lisa Hulse, and she is not only keeping us fed, she has also agreed to come up and sing something from her repertoire, which I am thrilled about. So, ladies and gentlemen, please welcome to the stage Lisa Hulse.
Si ti ne me pas
Lisa Hulst, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you, Lisa. I couldn't let her bring us candy without at least getting up and singing something. I can't waste that voice. Okay. We're going to try something. Well, quite frankly, we don't know how this is going to turn out. Huxley, the dog, he had a unique bark. His bark was big and powerful, and yet he was about that big. He thought he was bigger than he really was. And no, you can't bark like that. You're a tiny dog. You should have a little yap. But he didn't. He had this big bark. And a couple of months before he passed, for whatever reason, I decided to record his bark. And I recorded his bark on my phone. I went, I gotta get a recording of this. So I got a recording of his bark. And I brought his bark with me tonight. I also brought this. This is his monkey. And this is no ordinary monkey, ladies and gentlemen. Just you watch this. It squeaks. And it squeaks at 3 o'clock in the morning. When Huxley decides, I'm going to... I'll leave it right there. When Huxley decides, he's going to chew it. Yeah, but that's Huxley's... So I thought, you know what? Let's come up with something where I can use Huxley's bark and Huxley's toy squeak in a grand aria. Or a silly little piece of music, whichever you want to call it. Okay, Benoit, this is the one where we're going to need... Benoit's working in the little room there to keep us all powered. And this is gonna, well, we'll see how this goes. This could be fun. This is a piece that we've, after brainstorming for several hours, several days, this we've come up with a title, and this piece is called Huxley's Song.
Thank you.
That's Nikki's probably at home right now watching this, bawling her eyes out. That's okay. Okay. Speaking of silly stunts, where's my water? I need my.
In front of the case.
There we go. Thank you. I'm just gonna have a quick sip of water for this next little piece of silliness. I don't know why I agreed to do this, but I said I would do this. And I play the piano, but I play a lot of instruments, but I don't play a lot of instruments well. But I play a lot of instruments, and most of them I haven't played in decades. The trumpet I have not played in 30 years. And a friend of mine lent me a trumpet and said, you need to go up there and play the trumpet and piano at the same time and accompany yourself. So he lent me his trumpet. I have not played this thing in 30 years, about 25, 30 years. And we deliberately did not practice it because we wanted you to experience what it's like to pick up a trumpet after 30 years and try and play it. And there's every good chance that my lip will cave after two measures.
This would be a good time to go to the bathroom.
Yes. Yeah. Don says, yeah, for those of you watching online, if you need to go to the bathroom, or if you're watching online and you need to go, you know, make some coffee or order pizza, now's a good time to probably do it. All right. Let's go. This is My Funny Valentine. Let's give it a try.
Thank you.
Benoit, how do you...
Benoit, how do you do 3 shows a day, 6 days a week? Oh, gosh, that hurts. I can taste a mixture of... I think it's brass and blood. I'm not sure. Well, that was fun to try. I'll put it in its case and I'll be back in... Thank you. I'll be back in 30 years and try that again. Okay. Of course, being the Julian Bond trio, we've kind of developed this habit where we play a James Bond theme in every show we do. It may be the main James Bond theme. The last show we did the main James Bond theme, and we did Live and Let Die. So we have chosen for this show a theme that was written in 1977 by Marvin Hamlisch for the movie The Spy Who Loved Me. I see people in the audience going, yes, yes, yes. This is a piece called Nobody Does It Better from The Spy Who Loved Me. Thank you. Okay. We're going to do... actually, the band gets a break right now, because I'm going to do a piece that was requested. I put out some requests, and I did get this request. It's a piece that I have done before, but I enjoy playing. And those of you who know me know that there's no way I could get through a concert anyway without playing at least one piece by John Williams, right? It's just, oh, thank goodness they sang. Thank goodness you're playing some John Williams. So this is a slightly shortened version, because the original, I think, that I used to do was about 20 minutes long. But this is a little medley from John Williams' music from Harry Potter.
Thank you.
Thank you so much. Did you spot the wrong note? There was a wrong note in there. Maybe two. Well, we have one piece left to play, but I want to thank you for coming this evening. If you're watching online, thank you for your support. If you're watching here in person, thank you for your support, but also thank you for being here, and thank you for eating all the candy that's out there and the nibbles so that I won't eat them and get fat. I really appreciate your support. I know Huxley does. This has been a fundraiser to help with Huxley's expenses when he finally passed. We fought for 3 days to try and save his life, including bringing him back from a cardiac arrest. And he was just too sick, unfortunately. And we were not able to save him. But you know that hospital bills and vet bills both can be huge. And so this was at least my way of maybe trying to help offset some of those costs and give us a head start on paying that off. But also a chance to get to play with fine musicians like Bob and Don, because and Carol and Lisa, because any excuse to play with you guys and to make music is a great excuse. So but I want to thank you for supporting us this evening. And we're going to take this show out with a piece that, it's a piece by Rodgers and Hammerstein, but Don and I kind of played around with it and decided to take a different, slightly different approach to it. And it's, we're sitting here, we're playing with great musicians and great friends and great food and great company and a great, if you haven't been to the Timucua Performing Arts venue, oh my gosh, you need to come in here and check this place out. It's insane and it sounds great and it looks great and it feels great. And Benoit is great, and I want to thank Benoit for his time this evening. Thank you, Benoit. He's in the little booth there. Ah, there we go. He's been great to help us out this evening. I just realized we're surrounded by our favorite things. And that made us think, what about a song by Rodgers and Hammerstein? Any idea? There is nothing like a dame, that's right. Now this is our little twist on my favorite things. Thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen. Good night from all of us. Be safe.